What's up, guys? It's Josh again with Upstate Brush Control. We got a forestry job today, about an acre. Willie just got started with the trap door. So it's about where the telephone pole is, to about that telephone pole. So we'll get it opened up, do our thing. Hey, Micah.
Hey.
That's about somewhere in here, there's the other side. John went to pick up the new 135. It got fixed, so hopefully it doesn't make that whine noise anymore. So he's going to run up to Charlotte real quick to get that. So we got both cutter heads here, the Blackhawk and the trap door. So once he comes back, we'll be rolling. So stay tuned. So there's a good bit of tires in here, so I'm gonna hop in the excavator real quick. So like a pile back there, pull those out so Willie doesn't hit him with the cutter head. right, we got this front area opened up. There's a good bit of trash in that back corner, so we've been going through and picking that up. Got our trash pile here. So nice fan. So we'll try to get most of that out before Willie punches him over there. But other than that, it's going good. Going pretty fast. All right, it's going good. He's got a good bit finished off on the front side, so we can park the trucks in there. Guys, I'm back here on the job with the fellas, and as you can see, making great progress. I think it's a 1 acre lot. I'm not sure Josh went through all that stuff, Josh or Mike or Willie, whoever. But what I was doing was going and getting the 135. So
ate his back. It had some weird thing with the AC relay wasn't connected right or something like that. I don't know. Something with the AC wasn't working properly. They fixed that. Things only got 50 hours on it, 50, 60 hours, something like that. Ain't got no hours on it. But so I'll let you guys hear it here, but it's still making the whining noise. I thought it was some kind of relief valve or something going on with it. There's a definite whine in it. I'll put you guys in the cab and you guys can hear it, and then I'll take you down to the 120 and you guys can hear inside it. It's not the cutter heads. We know it's not the cutter heads because we switched cutter heads back and forth. We know it's not it, but we took it up to the dealership where we got it, CCE. They went through everything, checked some hoses, might have been rubbing or touching some of these steel lines. There's a lot of steel lines like this right here underneath the cab, connects to the pump and drive motor and all that stuff. So CCE went through everything, checked all the flows, checked everything. Everything was within spec and everything was good. So we know that having them just double check it, make sure it's good. But I don't know. It seems kind of crazy to spend the kind of money that we spent on this machine, and it's making this whiny. They're gonna fix it, no doubt about it. ASV and CCE, they're gonna fix it. But the biggest reason why I'm doing this is to figure out if anybody else is getting this whining noise. I had a couple people reach out to me, but please call me, email me. We're trying to figure this thing out. I'm not bad mouthing anybody. I'm not trying to do that at all. Every dealer or every brand is gonna have issues somewhere along the way. No machine is 100% perfect. We don't know if it's a pump. This does have a different pump, I think, in it than the 120. So just maybe how this pump sounds and how that pump sounds. So we really don't know. ASV is supposed to be coming out and taking a look at it. Cases guys, CCE guys. So it's just kind of frustrating. It's fine. The machine is working and operating just right, but for me, it's just that noise kind of bugs me, but because it doesn't sound right in my eyes, my ears, whatever you want to call it. But so I'm gonna let you guys hop in here with me, and we will go, we'll run a few minutes. Honestly, I'm not seeing a huge difference in power from this machine to my 120. It's just, I'm not seeing it. I'm definitely not seeing it, but I don't know. It just could be the time I haven't spent in this one as opposed to the time, that one's got 3,600 hours on it that we've all, me and Willie and Josh and Micah, we've all driven and stuff. So I'm gonna fire it up here real quick, turn on the cutter head, let you guys listen to it. I am running at 43 gallons per minute. I'm not running it full speed. This cutter head is not set up to run 50 gallons per minute. This thing is set up, tuned for 43 gallons per minute. That's what it's supposed to be at. That's what I set the computer to. So, all right, half throttle here, gonna kick it into high flow. So I don't know if you guys can hear that. That high pitch whine kind of comes and goes a little bit. Right now, the head is pretty much in full spool. right, guys, we're gonna wrap it up for the day, and we'll be back tomorrow to finish it up just a little bit more, but we don't have anything super pressing, so we're not gonna stay late, and there's a lot of traffic to get back to the shop. So yeah, it looks really good. Moving right along. Good bit of big material up here in this top section, but that's kind of what we figured. But I'd say another 50 feet along that edge, down to nothing over there, 50 feet over here, about that. There's a big oak, it goes right to that one. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and load it up. We're gonna take one machine back with us tonight, take this the old 120 back, leave this cutter head for finishing up along the road, and then we'll leave the Blackhawk on to get this big material. So we're probably gonna get these pines out of here. I don't know, we'll see how we're feeling. But they're kind of big. I mean, they're 10 inches at the base, every bit of that. But yeah, big difference. So we're gonna get cleaned up here, or get everything blown off, ready for tomorrow, and we'll be back.